Back on First at 5, I'm Stephanie Gorin. A skin condition is causing a lot of concern among parents. Eczema is a red rash that's so irritating, it's really hard not to kind of scratch at it. Well, Dr. First has the warning signs that your child might just have it.
Parents have been itching to ask me whether their young child's red rash, or perhaps this dinosaur's red rash, could be eczema. Well, let me do more than skin the surface on this particular topic. Eczema is a red, itchy rash made up of tiny little red bumps that sometimes ooze fluid or crust over. It's commonly found in about 10% of infants and young children from 0 to 5. What's interesting is 50% of the time it goes away by adolescence, but 50% of the time it goes on to be associated with other allergic illnesses like hay fever and even asthma. That's because eczema is an allergic reaction to something that irritates the skin. It could be pollen or mold, it could be secondhand tobacco smoke, it could be a wool fabric, it could even be stress or sweating. Something gets the skin upset and it starts to cause those little red bumps. Now, it turns out that there is no particular test to diagnose eczema except the appearance of the rash and possibly a family history. So where do you find it? Well, you might find it on a baby's cheeks, on their forehead, on their scalp. As kids get older, it shows up on their chest, on their arms and their legs, particularly in the creases of the elbow and behind the knees. Eczema can be extremely itchy, and the more kids scratch at an eczema rash, the more they're going to irritate it, inflame it, maybe even infect it to the point that your child's health care provider needs to prescribe antibiotics. So what do I recommend for the itching? Well, you need to give your child perhaps an oral antihistamine that will help reduce the itching effect, and you also want to give them a hydrocortisone cream or ointment over the inflamed skin, maybe one that's even stronger that requires a prescription from your child's health care provider. Of course, the best way to deal with eczema is not let these flares occur. So how can you do this? Well, don't let the skin dry out. If you tend to keep your child in hot baths all the time, well, that dries out the skin. So have your child take a quick shower, and then when they come out of the shower, pat the skin dry rather than rub it to inflame the skin, and then coat it with a moisturizing lotion or cream, and that will trap moisture inside the skin and reduce the severity of the flare. In addition, keep your kids well hydrated, and if you know what the allergic trigger is that causes eczema, keep your child away from that, so that hopefully tips like this will allow you to make some rational decisions when it comes to knowing a little bit more about how to deal with eczema. This is pediatrician Dr. Lewis First from Vermont Children's Hospital of Fletcher Allen, reminding you to always be first with your kids.